We're on the black carpet for gravity, where we hope to see some stars float by. But they might get caught in that debris field.
It took so long to develop the technology for this film, they don't really send people into space anymore.
Yeah, exactly. No, when we wrote this movie, we thought we were being so relevant by including the space shuttle in it, and now it's discontinued. They still send people, but up into Soyuz. So at least, you know, part of it is history, the space shuttle, but we still have the Soyuz. And the Shenzhou, which is, you know, the Chinese station, is not actually up in space, but there's talks about starting that program.
There are people right now up there.
Yeah?
Yeah. There's always someone there looking at you.
How was it doing the research for the film?
That was a lot of fun. Humbling, because you realize you know nothing, but it was a lot of fun.
So for the special effects heavy sequences, what is it like? What are some of the intricacies of acting with just your face?
Well, you don't actually just so much act with just your face, but because you luckily for us, you actually got to see certain things. There was like LED lights, so you could see things. It wasn't like working against a blue screen in a way. There was some other elements in it, so you actually got to. I could see pictures of Sandy flying across the screen and stuff. So okay. it was actually fun. It was a really interesting way of shooting. It's never been done before. So
that's every day. This film is nothing but special effect sequences. There was no normal set. Except for the tank, the water tank, where we were submerged in water. That was about as normal a set environment as we had. So every day was, you look to mad scientists and technicians to understand what they need, and you figure out how your body's going to give it to them.
In a film that is so special effects heavy, how do you draw the line between animation and live action?
Well, that was the big challenge in the whole film. Pretty much everything is both.
Oh, wow.
You know, and the challenge got how to make a seamless blend of the two of them.
So how does this movie factor into your post-Harry Potter game plan?
I had no game plan.
No? You have so many big movies. You have Paddington Bear.
That's shooting right now. No, you know, ultimately, I wish I could suggest that I had this great Uber plan. I just work on stories that I love and with people who I love. And when Alfonso asked me to get involved in Gravity, I said yes, because without even reading the script, because he's one of the greatest directors working today.
Well, sci-fi films typically don't do very well at award season, but you guys have some good buzz. What do you think you did right?
I think part of what we did right is we never set out to do a sci-fi movie. This movie, we took so much care to be very realistic and to like almost make a movie that was a space documentary gone wrong, that it's hard for me to call it sci-fi. I know it has a lot of people call it that. If anyone, I call it speculative fiction. It's more what if.
I also have to ask you, with all these franchises being revisited, like Star Wars and Lord of the Rings with The Hobbit, how do you feel going back to Harry Potter with Fantastic Beasts?
Well, I think it's great that she's doing it, because she wouldn't do it if she wasn't passionate about it and had a story to tell. She doesn't need to. But she's choosing to. And I think it's really exciting for all of us. It's going to be great.
Great. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.